Join our WhatsApp community and become a part of our super cool live hobby classes. Link is in the description.
Hi, my name is Nikhil and I welcome you all in this brand new series by the name Learn with CamKitWealth. And in today's video, we'll be learning about algebra. We'll be covering all the inside and outs of this topic within 10 minutes. So without wasting any time, let's get into the video. Alright, so before actually getting into the crux of algebra, let's first see as to what are we going to learn today. Let's just have a quick look at the index. So we'll be starting by learning what is an algebraic expression. Then we'll be moving to terms, factors, coefficients in an algebraic expression. Then we'll be talking about the types of algebraic expressions. We'll be talking about like and unlike terms, addition and subtraction of algebraic expressions. We'll also be talking about degree of a polynomial, multiplication of algebraic expressions, and at the end, we'll be talking about algebraic identities. So let's now talk about our first topic of the day, which is what is an algebraic expression. Let's just try to understand this concept in the layman's term. Talking in the layman's term, algebraic expression is an expression that is built up from integer consonants, variables, and algebraic operations. Now, in order to understand this concept, let's just have a look at this particular example. 5x minus 3. If we further break it into algebraic elements, we'll see that 5x and 3 here are referred to terms. What is in coefficient? The number attached to the variable is nothing but the coefficient. Now, the question is that what actually is this variable? Now, you might be seeing these alphabets x, y, z, a, b, c attached to some number. All these alphabets, when they are attached to a number, it refers to a variable. And if a number is not attached to any variable, in that case, it is referred to as a constant. And when these coefficients, variables, and constants are joined with an algebraic operation like addition or subtraction, then as a whole, this entire expression is referred to as an algebraic expression. Let's now take some more examples of such algebraic expressions and let's just try to spot the variables, coefficients, and constants separately. In the first example, you can see 5x plus 4y plus 9. Let's just try and spot out the variables here. The alphabets which are attached to any number like 5 and 4, like in this case, x is attached to 5 and y is attached to 4. So these x and y will be nothing but variables, something that we've already discussed before in the video. What are the coefficients here? The numbers attached to the variables are the coefficients. So in this case, 5 and 4 becomes the coefficients. And the number without any variable attached to it is nothing but the constant. So 9 becomes the constant in this case. Moving to the next example, 3xy minus 4z plus 50. Now we'll be taking this xy as a whole and not individually, because xy are not separated by any algebraic operation. And hence, xy will be taken as one single variable. Similarly, z is attached to 4, and hence z also becomes a variable here in this case. What are the coefficients? 3 is the coefficient to xy, and 4 is the coefficient to z, because these are the numbers which are attached to the variables. And 50, not being attached with any variable, becomes the constant in this case. Let's now move to the next topic and let's just try and see what are the types of algebraic expressions which we get to see. So there are majorly 5 algebraic expressions that we get to see: monomial, binomial, trinomial, quadrinomial, and polynomial. Now a monomial algebraic expression is the one in which there is just one term. Similarly, binomial, as the name suggests, is an algebraic expression wherein there are two terms joined with an algebraic operation like addition or subtraction. Similarly, trinomial is the one wherein there are three terms, quadrinomial there are four terms, and polynomial is something in which there are two or more terms. Therefore, binomial, trinomial, quadrinomial all falls into this category of polynomial algebraic expression. I believe the types of algebraic expressions are now clear to you guys, and let's now move to the next topic, which is like and unlike terms. Now, there's a very interesting concept to spot the like and unlike terms. You simply have to look at the variables of the algebraic expression and nothing else. We're not concerned about the constant terms. We are only concerned about the variable terms. Talking about the like terms, same variables with same powers are known as the like terms. Here, if you see 7xy and 53xy, the variable is the same, which is xy in both the cases. And the power to the variable is also the same, which is 1. and hence 7xy and 53xy becomes like terms. Similarly, 6x square yz square and 33x square yz square will only be looking at the variable terms. What are the variable terms here in both the cases? It's x square yz square. The variable terms are the same with the same powers, and hence 6x square yz square and 33x square yz square are also like terms. Now, talking about unlike terms, it is something very similar to the above topic. Different variables or same variables with different powers. So if we've got two different variables, or maybe if we've got same variables with different powers, then we'll be referring them to unlike terms. And let's now move to a very important topic, which is addition and subtraction of algebraic expressions. Now in this topic, we'll simply be using the concept of like and unlike terms. And if like and unlike terms are clear to you guys, then you'll be very easily be able to add and subtract two algebraic expressions. You can see there are two algebraic expressions given on the screen. 5xy plus 6x plus 4y plus z plus 5 and 20xy plus 7x plus 8y plus z plus 5. So what we'll do is, we'll simply consider the like terms. What are the like terms here? 5xy and 20xy are the like terms. 6x and 7x are the like terms. 4y and 8y are the like terms. And z are the like terms here. So now we simply need to add the like terms. If we add 5xy and 20xy, we get 25xy. Similarly, adding 6x plus 7x, we get 13x. And adding 4y plus 8y, we get 12y. And adding z and z, we get 2z. So what is the final result? The final result becomes 25xy plus 13x plus 12y plus 2z. Similarly, we'll be subtracting two algebraic expressions. 5xy plus 6x plus 4y plus z plus 5 and minus 20xy minus 7x minus 8y minus z minus 5. We'll simply be considering the like terms as we've done in the last case. What are the like terms here? 5xy and minus 20xy, 6x and minus 7x, 4y minus 8y, z minus z, 5 minus 5. So 5xy minus 20xy, what does it become? It leads to minus 15xy. Similarly, 7x minus 7x is minus x, 4y minus 8y is minus 4y, z minus z makes it a 0, and similarly 5 minus 5 makes it a 0 once again. So what is the final result here? We'll simply be writing these terms with the relevant algebraic operations, and it will lead to the final result, which is minus 15xy minus x minus 4y. And now when we've learned how can we add and subtract two algebraic expressions, let's now move to the next step, which is multiplying two algebraic expressions. Now on the screen, you can see that there's a simple approach written that you simply have to multiply each term of the first expression with each term of the second expression and write down the result. Now when you have to multiply these two expressions given on the screen, which is x plus y and 2x plus y plus z, what will we do? We'll simply write these two expressions together, x plus y, 2x plus y plus z, and we'll be multiplying each term of the first expression with each term of the second expression. X will be multiplied by 2x, then x will be multiplied by y, then z. And similarly, y will also be multiplied by 2x and y and z. Hence, we are multiplying each and every term of the first expression with each and every term of the second expression. So if you multiply x by 2x, it makes it 2x squared. X multiplied by y makes it xy, and x multiplied by z makes it xz. And when we multiply y with 2x, it makes it 2xy. Y with y makes it y square, and y multiplied by z makes it yz. And we are simply inserting the relevant algebraic operations in between, and that is what will give us the final result. And now let's talk about the last topic for this video, which is algebraic identities. Now, where are these algebraic identities actually used? These are used to solve your questions based on algebra. You simply have to learn these four identities that you can see on the screen, and you'll be good to solve each and every question that you face in algebra. Talking about the first identity, a plus b whole square. A plus b whole square makes a square plus b square plus 2ab. A minus b whole square makes a square plus b square minus 2ab. Similarly, a square minus b square is equal to a plus b and a minus b. And talking about our last identity, x plus a multiplied by x plus b is equal to x square plus whole bracket a plus b into x plus ab. Now we'll not be getting into the depth of these algebraic identities, but I've told you about the four major identities that will be used in this topic. You simply have to learn them, and you'll be able to solve majorly all the questions that you face in algebra. And with this, we come to the end of the video. We hope you guys liked it. If yes, then make sure that you give it a like. And also, don't go without subscribing the channel and clicking the bell icon. And also, if you wish to learn more from CamKit Quill, and if you want to be a part of our student community, then you can simply go in the description box and you'll see a WhatsApp link on the top. You can simply click on that link and you can join the WhatsApp group and you will be a part of the CamKit Quill community. We've got a lot of cool stuff happening in our CamKit Quill student community. Make sure that you also join that community and take full benefit of it. And we'll see you guys in the next video. By that time, this is CamKit Quill signing out. Thank you so much.